立法會主席
The President Quorum call. Address. Mr. YIU Si-wing will address the Council on the report of the Committee on Members' Interests on a complaint against Mr. Andrew Leung. Mr. YIU Si-wing. Madam Deputy, on behalf of the Commission of Members' Interests, CMI for short, I submit the report. In November last year, the Commission received a complaint against Mr. Leung Kwan-yuen. Based on a number of media reports, the complainant alleged that Mr. Leung owned shares of two companies registered in the United Kingdom. As a result, he has breached the requirement for registration under the rules of procedure. These two companies are called SHL and OGL for short. We have held four meetings to look into the complaint, and we have on two occasions asked Mr. Leung to provide explanation and information in writing to assist in the investigation. In the relevant period, that is within 7 years before the complaint was received, Mr. Leung has only made one registration in relation to the holding of shares of the two companies on the 19th of October last year, that is the day after the media report. In relation to the first company, SHL, Mr. Leung indicated that SHL is only a representative office of his family business. Its main business is to provide services to clients in Europe. SHL has only reissued one share, and during the relevant period, he only held half a share. Given the fact that Mr. Leung has admitted that he did not register the share of SHL in the relevant period, the committee determined that Mr. Leung has breached the ROP 83 bracket 1 rule in relation to registration. As a result, part of the complaint related to SHL is substantiated. However, there is no information indicating that Mr. Leung a failure to register is a deliberate act, nor is his role as a legal member a conflict of interest. On top of that, based on past experience in handling similar cases, the committee decided not to recommend any sanction against Mr. Leung for the breach. In relation to the other company, OGL, Mr. Leung indicated that OGL owned a freehold land of a property in London, and this company has a shareholder CEC to which Mr. Leung was a remunerated director and shareholder. In Mr. Leung's first reply to the committee, he admitted that he holds shares of OGL. And since CEC holds shares of an OGL because the shares were somehow transferred to him. The committee later learned from the official website of the Company House of the UK and OGL's annual return. Well, the committee downloaded the annual return of OGL from the official website of Company House in the UK. So we asked Mr. Leung to clarify the details of the transfer. In Mr. Leung's second reply to the committee, he said that originally he assumed the information stated on the annual return was correct. So he mistook that the transfer indeed took place. As a result, in his first reply, he admitted that he held the shares of OGL. And did not register this interest. However, the lawyer of CEC clarified, and Mr. Leung confirmed that the transfer did not happen. And considering Mr. Leung's further clarification and the relevant information, we accept his explanation that he did not hold OGL's share in the relevant period. So this complaint is unsubstantiated. However, well, in Mr. Leung's first reply, he did not confirm the information and provide the wrong information to us. As a result, we were disappointed with his reply. Heads, committee stage. Council is now in committee to continue the consideration of this.